हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नमस्ते एंड वेलकम टू अल्पा एक्टिव लर्निंग। टुडेस टॉपिक इज इंग्लिश टेंसेस पार्ट टू। सो इफ यू हैव नॉट सीन माय पार्ट वन, डू वॉच दैट वीडियो एंड हियर वी गो। पास्ट टेंस, सो व्हाट इज सिंपल पास्ट टेंस? भूतकाल। सो लुक एट द टाइमलाइन, एनीथिंग विच यू वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट द पास्ट इंसिडेंट, पास्ट थिंग्स, we used simple past tense. So what are the key? The key is either we use the second form of the past tense, that is V2, or we have a helping verb was, were, had, and the question is asked with did. Remember, if you find was, were, had, did, these are the helping verb. For the to be, I was, we were, you were, he, she, it was, and they were. So, for the past tense, was is used for I, he, she, and it, whereas for the plural, we, you, and they, we use were. Now, for to have form, for every form, I, we, you, they, he, she, it pronoun, the only form is had, because past tense of have is had. She made a decorative frame. I gave my book to you. We ate fruits. You drank coffee. Now look at these highlighted red words. Scored, made, gave, ate, and drank. These are the past tense of the verb. Certain verb has the past tense where we just put ed, whereas in certain verb the entire word is changed. Now, affirmative, negative, and interrogative type of past tense. Now we have, you must have remember, we have used the word I go. So we know the past tense of go is went. So I went, we went, you went, they went, and he went. Here only you should know its correct past form of the verb. Now, for negative, we never say I not went. Here, be careful. You must know the main base form of the verb here. So, went, the main base form is go. And in past tense, we use did. Right? So, I did not go. We did not go. And you did not go. He did not go, they did not go, did, right? So, do ka past tense did. Now, how to make questions? So, if you know I did not go, the question start from did I go, did we go, did you go, did they go, okay? So, remember here did for making the questions as well as for negative. Sentences did is very, very important. Now, past continuous tense. As you have read in the present tense, continuous means ing. So, here we are talking about a thing which was continuous in the past. Now, it is over, but that was there in the past. So, keywords, helping verb was and were plus ing to the given verb. So, was plus verb plus ing. Children, verb and ing together is known as present participle. I was drawing the map of India. We were playing football in the garden. You were flying kite. She was reading a novel. They were talking in the lab. Now look at here the highlighted words with was, were, and ing form. But remember, past continuous tense is always used along with the past tense. So, like I was drawing the map of India when he came. We were playing football in the garden when my mother called me. She was reading a novel when father came. They were talking in the lab and the teacher shouted. Generally, past continuous tense is always being used along with the past tense. Now, again, affirmative, negative, and interrogative type of past continuous tense. So, I was going. Very simple now to make this negative, I was not going. Same way, we were not going, you were not going. Only in case of he, it is he was going, he was not going. So now how to form the interrogative? Use the helping verb was. Was I going? Were we going? Were you going? And was he going? So making the question, and if you know how to make the questions, writing the answer will be more easy. Now past perfect tense. It is used to describe an action which had been completed in the past before the another action was started. हमने भूतकाल में कोई एक एक्शन शुरू की थी, वो खत्म हो गई थी और कोई एक्शन शुरू करने से पहले. So here, it is used in simple sentences when the sentences contain the words like, already, before, never, since and till. The keyword had form plus past participle. Remember, the past tense of have is had. Now, look at the example. He had already done his work. I had never seen the Taj Mahal before. We had not met since her marriage. She had not written a single page till yesterday. They had never spoken about it. So here, as I said, already, before, since, till, these are the words which suggest us that. Now, past perfect continuous tense. So here, some action in the past was continued. It is used to denote an action which had been going on in the past for a long time, or an action which had been going on before the another action in the past. The keywords are had, been, and ing form, that is present. I had been teaching here for 5 years. He had been playing for 2 hours when it rained. It had been raining since morning. You had been making cards since yesterday. We had been learning through virtual from July. So, for 5 years, for 2 hours, since morning, since yesterday, and from July. So the time period is given. So action was started in the past. Now, simple future tense. Bhavishyakal. Very simple. Shall or will plus work. So here, we shall play football today evening. So the action which is not started, which is going to start in the nearest future, it can be after 2 hours, after a day, after a week, month, year, or maybe after 2-3 years or anything. So, he will stay in Mumbai for a week. She will give her exam tomorrow. You will bring essay book tomorrow. They will go for a movie in the night show. So, to identify future tense is very simple, children. With will or shall, you have the base form. Now, future continuous tense. As I said, continuous means to put ing. It is used to denote an action that will be going on in the future. So here it's your prediction or you are guessing that my work will be continue in future. So keywords shall be, will be, plus present participle, that is verb plus ing. So I shall be singing new songs in the prayer. So ye prayer mein aap gana gaate, आप गाना गा रहे होंगे. He will be going to Pune next week. You will be playing in the next World Cup. They will be writing exam after a week. We will be running in the race. So many a times will is also used for some supposition, some prediction, or we may not be sure. Now future perfect tense. It is used to denote the completion of an action at some future time. So again, you just want to say that in the future, my this work will be completed. So keyword shall have, will have plus third form of the verb. I shall have done my work by 10 p.m. We will have finished his work before you reach. We shall have drawn rangoli on the floor by tomorrow. You will have sung sweetly in the competition and they will have learnt in couple of days. Now look at here, shall have, will have. Now do, did, done. So done is used. Finish, finished, finished. Draw, drew, drawn. Sing, sang, sung. Learn, learnt, learned. Future perfect continuous tense. It is used to denote an action that will have been going on for some time in the future. So here shall have been plus present participle, that is verb and ing, or will have been and verb plus ing. So we shall have been playing chess for an hour before you arrive. आपके आने से पहले शायद हम लोग चेस खेल रहे होंगे. Second, he will have been studying since morning. वो शायद सुबह से ही पढ़ाई करता होगा. So again, all these are one kind of your prediction, your supposition. So thank you very much once again. Do like and comment on my video. Subscribe my channel for the new videos.